Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. I did not disappear. If I did disappear, I came back with some fire for you. And this is the Vintage Fire plugin, our first plugin. I've been working behind the scenes. I had to keep it silent because it was a long, long process. But for months, I've been working on this for you. And finally, it is here. So let me show you how to install it and any plugin for this matter. So this applies to any plugin you want to install. So firstly, once you download the plugin, it's called Vintage Fire. I'll leave a link below if you want to learn more about the plugin. But long story short, you download what's called a zip folder. This zip folder is a compressed folder that you have to unzip in order to access the stuff inside. So it looks like this if you're on a PC, Windows 10. Now, if you don't have any extraction tools like 7-Zip or ZIPEG or any WinRAR, stuff like that, you can simply click on it and double click. Right, and it says extract all. So what you have to do is extract this to a location. So you would go to extract all and then pick a specific folder. So you go browse, you pick any folder you want. It could be your download folder, your desktop, whatever. It doesn't really matter where you unzip this folder to. In this case, I have a folder within my downloads folder called Vintage Fire, and then you're going to extract it there. Okay, so once you extract, it's going to take a while, so I'm not going to make you watch me extract the folder. So once it's extracted, it won't have that little zip icon on the folder anymore. It's going to look like it's an open folder. You just double click to open up the folder, double click again. And here it says 64-bit setup. So we're working on the Mac version as well. So we'll have a Mac version as well. It's the same process. There's only one thing about this install that you have to do correctly, and it's simple. So just double click. It's going to load up the installer. And once this bad boy kicks up, I'll show you how to install it. So anyway, that's where we've been away doing. We've also updated our music theory courses. We've updated premium with a business course in there. A lot has gone down within the last month. All right, so that's my dog barking. But anyway, I'm at a family's house. So here it says Vintage Fire PC 64-bit version 1. We're going to hit next. And we're going to hit agree. I agree. There's really anything. Okay, so make sure your destination folder is this. Okay, so if you change it, it's going to mess up the uninstall installer. So just leave it by default. You don't have to do anything. And I'll show you how to get inside of FL Studio. So yes, it's already directed to the right place. Just hit next. Mine's already installed, so I'm not going to install it again. But let's open up FL Studio, and I'll show you how to import it inside of FL Studio. So hit install. It's going to install all the sounds. Okay, so now you're in FL Studio, and you want to install your new Vintage Fire plugin. So what we're going to do is go to options up top. Let's go to manage plugins. And this is what I love about FL Studio. You can install plugins from multiple folders. And this is the best feature that I think other DAWs need to hop on because this is awesome. So for example, if you scroll down, it says you can hit this plus folder icon and you can import any folder you want. So the folder you need to import, hit plus. We're gonna go to this PC. We're going to go to your C drive or your core drive. We're gonna go to program files. And we're going to go to VST plugins. All right. And that will be the folder in which you've installed the program. So you hit OK and it will add it to this list to the left. You can also add more folders. I suggest adding more folders like, you know, based on the company name or based on X86. So you would go to plus. Let me just show you. It's easier to just show you than explain it. You go to this PC, C drive. And for example, I would add more folders like program 86, and then I would go to VST plugins here and then do all of your folders that say VST plugins. This way you install from all locations, even this folder here that's just under C drive automatically. Click that and do that as well. So once you have that, you can do a rescan and then also do rescan plugins with errors just in case you installed it wrong the first time, and then hit find plugins and it's going to do a long search. But once you search, it will work and you'll find it right under, if you go to vendor sort, you can see BusyWorks Beats, you'll find Vintage Fire right here. And then click this little check icon to add it to your list of plugins. So now it's added. You go to your channel rack, hit the plus icon and you'll see Vintage Fire right here under the list. And you can check out different sounds. I don't have a MIDI controller on me, so I'm just clicking stuff. Alright, so you got a lot to work with. I'll show you how this thing works in the next video. Thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.